Hi everyone, I'm Channa Gunawardana. This car manufactured in UK. The last owner of the car company was BMW. Since 2000 they have not manufactured this model, mini model. Anyway, why suddenly cars? This time T4, pre-seen for August and November 2014 exams are based on a car manufacturing company. Now how T4 works? There's a pre-seen given for you, and on the exam day you get another document called unseen. Pre-seen is lot of details about the company, how they manufacture cars, how they design cars, how they sell cars. All those details are given in the pre-seen. In addition, you will get to know their financials, how established they are financially. Then you will have enough time to study about the pre-seen. On the exam day you get the unseen, the latest details related to the same company. Based on the unseen exam requirement, the challenge for you is to write a report. Write a report which addresses the key issues faced by the company, evaluate them, analyze them, and give appropriate recommendation for the issue. So in a way, it's simple and straightforward. You have the details of the company, you review what's happening in the company, identify the business issues, and you find solutions for the problems that faced by them. So this is the course that we are trying to help you with. At TCP, we have a fully structured course for you. We are a small organization, quite small. We would like to remain small. However, we have been recording exceptionally high pass rates. We just got the pass rate for our institute, the global pass rates, country pass rates for May 2014 exams. We have recorded exceptionally high pass rates because, well, we are passionate about what we do. We are serious about what we do. Our theory is if you fail, we fail. So we are working hard on that. At the same time, our course includes many different strategies which will help you to pass. So I'm sure you will enjoy them as you go on. So these are quick video. This is the first one. We'll have many videos like this and many audios as we go on. There will be many audios on our key strategies. I'm sure you will enjoy when you join us how different strategies developed by us for you to pass the exam. I would like to welcome all my students online. I would like to welcome students from Wisdom and students from the CFO program to enjoy our course. Let's now start looking at the pre-seen and some of the quick details about the case. Let's look at the pre-seen for August-November 2014 T4 exams. What you see on the screen is the pre-seen, which is EL Car Company. What do? They involved in designing, development, manufacturing, marketing and selling of cars. Where are they based? They are based in Asia. When they have started their operations? In the next paragraph, they are given role of the government, how the government had been helping the industry. Then in the next subheading, growth of EL, the history of EL. Then some interesting details about the structure, strategy and the leadership of the organization. Within that you will see details such as about their IT systems. They have 45,000 people worldwide. Look at their market share, 4% globally, 12% locally. And then in the same document we have been given the details about the shareholding of the family, which is 55%. So likewise, there are many details given in the pre-seen throughout as you move on. Now when you go through the SEMA pre-seen, we want you to look at our KYP as well. Know your pre-seen. Know your pre-seen is nothing new. These are the same details given in the pre-seen. We are presenting it in a better format, a user-friendly format for you. There's nothing new here. Of course, there are few slides which we have marked with an E, which gives you little additional information. Otherwise, same information. Then what's the purpose? Look at it. We have organized them better. We have taken details from different pages of the pre-seen and put them into one place in a structured way. Now you will see the company profile, the industry, the name of the company, home country, head office, when we have started our business, former CEO, the present CEO, he's quite new, right?
So you can expect some challenges on the exam day, the shareholding, number of employees, further details related to the company given in one place. They are making profits based on 2030. So you will get a snapshot about the company much faster. Not only that, then you will see the country profile. There's nothing new here. They are from the precinct, but we have organized them to one place for you to understand about the country better. These are different dates that are given in the precinct. Again, we have reorganized for you to see the summary of the history of the company. Industry background, this slide you will see there's an E there, which means not from the precinct. We have given the definition of automobiles. The word auto means self, mobile means movable. And what happened in the industry in the past, and some of the interesting events that happened in the industry. Good for you to know. Be familiar with the industry. Start to build an interest about the industry. We will do that with you when you join us to study for T4 for August and November. So I'm not trying to go through the entire KYP with you, but you will see Asia's largest auto companies and all that. But I'll quickly jump into a different page just to highlight some of the other things that I would like to look at. Page number 87. The details given here are about the new product developments. Now this details is directly from the pre-seed, where it says we are trying to go into the upmarket products. And other slides are with an E, that means they are not from the pre-seed. We are trying to show you some of the examples of the upmarket products. By the way, why you should know this? Now, why you should know that we are trying to go into upmarket products? Let me show you the evidence. Look at our mock 1 for August 2014 exams. Obviously, I'm not trying to go through the entire mock 1 here. Don't worry about it. But look at some of the things that we are trying to do with you in mock 1. These are the latest revised numbers for 2015. Not given in the pre-seen, but given in our mock 1 in ANSI. Mid-range, we are trying to manufacture 400,000 units only. So why 400,000 units only from mid-range? What was given in the pre-seed? Go to the pre-seed, go to page number 18 of the pre-seed and see how many units we are trying to manufacture from the mid-range. 940,000 units, which has reduced in the unseen now in Mach 1. Based on the pre-seed, 940,000 from the mid-range, 300,000 from the executive range. Look at the Mach 1, it's going other way around. So we are trying to reduce the mid-range, we are trying to increase the executive range. So we are trying to go into more executive range. Why did we write this mock paper like that? It's directly coming from the pre-seen KYP. We are trying to move on to high-end products. So that is why it's important for you to go through this KYP. So what else is given in the pre-seen? Then you will see the basic operations of the company. Look at the details of supply, technological innovation, new product development, manufacturing. So much details are being given about the manufacturing. What's the easiest way to learn about manufacturing? What's the easiest way to learn the manufacturing process? Of course, you can go through our KYP. It explains a lot of things about how the manufacturing is done. But this is much easier.
The robots work first.
If you don't keep up your area, you'll get behind.
Every burst of sparks is another world made. takes more than 3,600 precision welds to build the underbody. The finished result is one solid unit of steel, a critical component in what makes the X3 handle like a sports car.
So there are many videos like this. When you join the course, go into our support material section of the online forum, then you will see a section called T4 Cinema, which has many videos related to the industry. Now, when you go through the pre-scene like this, the other thing that you got to do is try to predict what could come on the exam day. Now, look at this page, supply. Now, they are talking about supply to our organization. Now, look at this line. That said, however, its attitude to its suppliers is an ambiguous one. Sometimes shifting from supplier to supplier in an attempt to get the lowest price. At other times, developing close cooperative relationships. So in a line like that, you must be able to predict what would come. Now look at this, read it again. What would be there on the exam day? Obviously, for August or November, you can expect many problems with the suppliers. They are refusing to work with us. They are refusing to give us the price reductions. They are refusing to give us the best quality. How will you manage situations like that? Or from other hand, examiner will need you to develop relationship with the suppliers on the exam day. How will you do that? Are you ready? You need to do cultural changes internally. Because our present culture is buy from the cheapest. You can't do that. You need to develop KPIs to evaluate suppliers. Are you ready internally? Is your structure ready to develop relationship with all your suppliers? Maybe you need to have a senior person, preferably a director, who will look at the supply chain. Or on the exam day, it may be the backward integration. So from one line, you can predict many different examples. Now, for you to do that, there are two things that you need to know. Number one, you need to know the industry very well. So it's very important for you to be familiar with the industry, and this document I am sure will be a help in doing that. These are industry guide number one. We'll try to issue one more. Now this will have the details about the basic industry, the industry timeline, what happens in the history of the industry. Then you see the manufacturing of cars, which country is manufacturing most, the total manufacturing, car manufacturing in the world. These are world largest in 2014, 2013, Asia's largest, largest in USA, largest in Germany, in China, highest selling cars. Then you get details about the individual companies. Toyota, likewise, it continues with many different companies, and you will know about details about the individual companies. After that, it starts with the exam focused industry examples. Ford declaring dividend in this month. This is about General Motors in July 2014. Look at what's happening internally. Look at this. In January 2014, Ford has unleashed plans for a prototype solar powered hybrid car. There's a solar panel here, and how many miles it can run with the solar powered vehicle. Likewise, this is happening with the strikes in the industry, so you might see one on the exam day as well. And this is Toyota in India, the trouble that they have with labor. So one of the other document that you should be going through is this industry example, industry guide, and it's critical for you to know what's happening in the industry. Other interesting document that we will give you is this. Look at this. There are three things in this document. Number one, what's happening in the industry. Number two, we link that to the pre-sale. Number three, we link then to the possible issues. Now these are the excess capacity issues in the industry. Then we are telling you what is given in the pre-scene. Pre-scene is talking about excess capacity. You can see this line is directly from the pre-scene. Then the possible issues. Likewise, mergers and acquisitions. Now in mergers and acquisitions, you will see we are giving the industry mergers and acquisition examples. I'm sure you are familiar with some of these examples. If not, read our industry guide again. Then what is given in the pre-scene? Pre-scene is talking about mergers and acquisition. Then we are trying to see what the possible issues would be. Strikes. Now this is a dangerous common event in the industry. Auto recalls. Now pre-scene is talking about it, and it's happening in the real world. So only thing that could happen on the exam day is the examiner will give you a question on that. If it is given in the pre-scene, if it is happening in the real world, what else you could do? So sales and marketing. Now if you go to the pre-scene talks about spending a lot of money on sales and marketing. They are telling me somewhere in this document, in recent years, therefore it has spent millions of dollars in high profile advertising. This is about EL. Millions of dollars. Well, here we go. These are some real world numbers. 30 seconds, how much it can cost. These are in USD millions. Of course, justification is here. So this is what is given in the pre-sale. The same thing that I just read, in recent years, therefore it has spent millions of dollars. So now what could happen? What could be the possible issues based on this? So please read this document along with the pre-scene. When you read the pre-scene, please use these documents around. I'm sure it will be helpful for you to understand what is given in the pre-scene. So marketing and sales. Now I'm just looking at the first 6 pages of the pre-scene, the key events that are given in the pre-scene. Don't forget, try to predict what the possible issues could be.
Based on the documents we issued, let's look at in which industry we are in. Of course, we are manufacturing cars. We are a car manufacturer. So one might say, broadly looking at, we are in the transportation industry, which is true. But then again, we are not in the entire area of the transportation industry. We are in the land transportation. Maybe we can further specify to say we are in the passenger transportation. But then how will you justify people spending $4.5 million on a Lamborghini? I think there's something else other than for moving from A to B. Money that you spend on a car will represent your personal wealth, your personal status. So then the question would be, what would be our substitute? Oh, then really, in which industry we are in? Now the substitute would be, where else people would spend money, if not cars, to show their personal wealth? Whatever the answer comes to your mind, that's the substitute for us. So this is a quick view on which industry we are in. There are 87 million vehicles produced in 2030. Out of this, 22 million came from China. So China becoming the world largest vehicle manufacturer for 2013. Second, USA, they manufactured 11 million. Third, Japan, 9 million vehicles. So did you notice? China is manufacturing 2 times of the vehicles that USA is manufacturing. So China is on top of the list. They are on top of the list of most of the things, even in the vehicle manufacturing. But then if you go through our industry guide and the other document, and if you see the top 10 car manufacturers in the world, you will not see many Chinese companies in the list. You will see US, German, Japanese companies in the list, but not many Chinese companies in the list. Actually, the biggest in China is the 10th in the list of world largest car manufacturers. And they are only manufacturing 3.5 million cars for the year. So you can see, even though China is large, they don't have one single large car manufacturer. There are 830 million vehicles on the roads. What does that mean? The vehicles are very important, I'm sure. That's why we have so many vehicles on the roads. Number two, I'm sure they must be polluting the environment a lot. So that this is a concern for the entire globe. This is a concern for everyone. So being EL car manufacturers, we better be careful about the damage to the environment and find ways to manufacture environmental friendly cars. I mean, there are so many things that can be done to ensure your car is environmental friendly.
there are 51 types of hybrid cars for you to select. And you can do a lot of things. If you drive at 50 kilometers per hour instead of 70 kilometers per hour, if you drive slow, you're going to save 20% of your fuel consumption. So those are the things you can do at your end. Is it easy to find details about the car manufacturing industry? Just Google, type car manufacturing industry, you will get 273 million hits. 273 million. So you have too much of information about the industry. It's very easy to get the information about the industry. There are some cars in the history that got more attention than others. The car of US President, which is manufactured by GM, got the media attention in many times. And there are other cars. If you recollect the TV series Knight Rider, the intelligent car that was there was quite interesting. I'm sure you should watch little from the movie so you will see what the future of cars are going to be. Auto recalls is very common but very dangerous. Only in 2013, 22 million vehicles were recalled in US. What does that mean? Is it an industry where the final quality of the product is that bad? Look at only Toyota. Since 1985, they have recalled 38 million vehicles. So what does this say? Toyota is supposed to be one of the best manufacturers in the world. There are books written about the Toyota manufacturing system. But still, 38 million vehicle recalls. So is it bad quality? Or is it really something else happening in USA? Is it the culture of US? Or are the safety regulators are trying to be too much? Which one is that? Innovation is one of the key in the industry. If you look at the top 10 innovative companies in the world, at least half are from our industry. $100 million had been spent as an industry on the innovation in the last year. Now, innovation in what? Innovation in the manufacturing is very common. And even the innovation happens to help you to drive. Well, when you drive, your eyes got to be on the road. But sometimes we tend to look at the messages, SMS and all that. So innovation will help you to concentrate on what you should be concentrating whilst you drive. There are auto brake systems available. There are visual warning systems available to help you. As far as innovation is concerned, you have connected cars. The cars that will talk to each other. And you have self-driven Google cars. So there are enough examples for the innovative vehicles in the market. On a different note, look at the profits made by one of the car companies. Look at Toyota. They have a $17 billion profit. So try to mesh the stories together and see how can they make that money. How much is the cost that they have spent on the recall in the cars? Is it a big event financially or not? Can they make $17 billion profit after doing that as well? And how much they spend on advertisements? You will see on our examples, it's $4 million for 30 seconds on the football games. You will be able to see some of those nice advertisements on the forum as well. So we will do some videos like this where we connect different industry examples. You can watch the video, then you remember the industry, then you remember the example.
Maybe there's one more document that I can quickly show you. If you are more familiar with the numbers, maybe this might be helpful for you. Pre-seen in numbers. So this is just in the draft copy. We are trying to develop it and issue it hopefully by tomorrow. This is, if you are familiar with the numbers, you will find it easier to go through with this. Now, having said this much of information about the pre-seen, why do people fail T4? Is it because they find it difficult to understand the pre-seen? Not at all. Everyone understands the pre-seen very well. They fail T4 because they don't have a strategy. So it's very important for you to have a proper strategy of how to pass T4. Let's look at our views on the strategy now.
We have developed many different strategies to ensure you pass. At TCP, we have been speaking to many students about 1 month before the exam, just before the exam, just after the exams, and with the results. We have been analyzing them over a period of time, using the data collected from many different countries. With that, we have come up with few best strategies to be followed. The first one is strategy 56. Then we move on to plan B,
as our second strategy. Then when the exams are close, we go for our third strategy called your potential. So let's look at what this first strategy means. Strategy 56. Strategy 56 means trying to get 56 marks out of 100. Why 56? Well, taking lower marks won't make any sense. So getting 56 is always better than getting anything lower. But the question would be, why not 75 out of 100? Why not 85 out of 100? There's a logic. Whenever you try to go for 85 marks, or whenever you feel you can go for 85 marks, there's a chance that you might ended up getting 46 marks. This is applicable for the students who fail the exam with 24 credits, 23 credits, 22 credits and so on. Whenever you feel you can go for 85 marks, you will try to do an excellent job, a perfect job for the sections at the beginning of the paper, like for the prioritization section, like for the discussion section. But the cost of that would be, you will not be able to complete the report, or you will not do a reasonably a good job for the last few parts of the section. So therefore, we have developed this strategy to push the students to get 56 marks. Well, that's not the end. When you reached 56 marks in our first few marks, then we will go into the next strategies of plan B and your potential, where we will push you to go for a higher mark. But it starts with strategy 56. Wherever you study, wherever you are, you need to follow a structured way to pass T4 exams. At TCP, what we do is, we have two stages that are going parallel at the beginning. The first one is called KYP, Know Your Precinct. The second one, which runs parallel, is called Ground Rule, GRs. GR means, ground rule means, rules applicable for you to pass the exam. So those rules will cover the post-exam guidelines and the strategies that we had developed at TCP, which will help you to pass. Once you finish those two, there will be a next stage, which is two practice mock exams. Now those two, you don't need to write answers under exam conditions. Those two mock exams comes with the answers for you to review the answer and see whether you had learned the ground rules right. So this section is like a test for your ground rule section. Now for the KYP section, there's a separate test, which is to see whether you have understood the KYP, which means over 200 short questions for you to answer. So if you can answer them well, that means the KYP is good. If you can do those two mock exams, then that means your ground rule section you have done well. Once you finish that, then we will move on to mocks under exam conditions. So for the November 2014, we will give up to 12 mock exams in total. So 10 mock exams you can do under exam conditions, and most of it we will mark. Then what you see is the individual discussions and the feedback for your mock exam. So follow something similar wherever you are, wherever you study. So you will be able to complete the T4 exams in August and November 2014 and avoid doing the integrated case study under the new syllabus. T4 is not a difficult exam to pass. Contrary to what some of you all may think, SEMA wants you to pass. There are no tricks in T4 paper. It's about a real world company where you need to identify the issues faced by them, evaluate them, analyze them, and give appropriate business recommendations. So it's overall straightforward, simple job. So we wish you all the very best for the exams in August and November. Pass the exams, get the membership, be an effective, efficient, qualified management accountant, and help the companies to do better, grow faster, and enjoy your life.